Alright, Pacesetter tournament. Let's get into it. Sure what car to take. Not gonna take the Hypersport. It's way too tail happy. This Onyx concept, it's alright. It's a little understeery, but it's pretty smooth. Mm. 509 isn't too bad. Between these two. Now I'll go ahead and try the Ferrari out. I think the Onyx would be better suited for this, but we'll see. Like driving a rally car. Very little visibility. Pretty good, almost like a GT3. Just gotta try to push a little harder. Push a little too hard. Seventh. Okay, the seventh place, that wasn't really that tough. The only thing that made it tough was, as I said, the visibility in the car. Is there's very little visibility through the windshield. I know this course, so this course is very easily, not many tight turns, probably like a couple. Most of it you could just lift off the throttle and make the turns, but with the visibility it's hard for me to look ahead of me. I like to look two turns ahead and I couldn't even see barely the car in front. But extra challenge, so we'll deal with it. Okay, on to round two. And it's at night. I'm not sure which track this one is. It's hard to see. So here we have another challenge. Car with minimal visibility racing with minimal visibility. see if you mess up the corner here. This car feels really good. Feels like a GT3 car. Pacesetter turning. And it's in the rain. I don't mind racing in rain. I actually prefer racing in the rain. I love doing rain races. This car, I don't know. I've never done this car in the rain, so we'll see. See how this goes. Splashing up on the side, I can't really see out the corner. Oh, broke too hard there. Section coming. time. Fourth place and drop to third. Oh well. Did one target. Okay, that one is done, so next we'll be moving on to turbocharge.